going on this one?
Kane, down the lane. Wood, mishandled, picks it up.
Wood should have been at the rim.
And that one goes down for Ghazi.
The shooting percentage to determine the outcome for them. He wants the team to make winning plays, and that doesn't always come when you're shooting the ball well. You got to be able to do those things when you're not shooting it well and still manage to win.
Absolutely.
Nice drive to the back.
Govan in for the first time. Peak with a head of steam, lost control. Garrett looks to counter. Ghazi's ahead of the pack.
By Govan, scoring inside on the offensive rebound, contesting the shot defensively, and then running the court hard to open up that shot for LJ Peak.
It outscored DePaul 15-5 in this second half. Hamilton working hard inside against Govan. Hamilton gets it, faces up, got loose with a dribble. Here's Ghazi, who stuffed one home in the first half.
Billy might have gotten away with the travel there.
Simpson on the drive, throws it up with the left hand. It won't go, but another turnover. This is Simpson to bring it across. Lots of three, takes it. You can see 16 total turnovers here in the first half. Just over midway through, even on both sides. Ghazi to the rim. Play on top, Palmer into the corner. Three to shoot. Six has to put it up. Desperation shot there, not close. On the bounce pass. Puts it on the deck. Left hand all the way to the rim.
Had a whale of a career at Wyoming, but Steve is a very aggressive, very committed recruiter. And there's a really nice job.
Matthews going to the basket. Can't finish, and Eli Kane brings it across for DePaul, and a nice feed to Ghazi, who's
loose ball, a scramble. Simpson picks it up in the backcourt.
Yeah, Dave has got our old friend Rick Carter. He's certainly been around. He was at Michigan State, Xavier.
Carter, a manager at Michigan State for Tom Izzo. Inside, Ghazi off the glass and in.
Currington misses from the wing, but Ghazi there to clean it up. Billy Garrett. No good, but the tip back. The short corner three. And climbing the ladder is Aaron Simpson, the North Chicago native, senior for this DePaul squad as it comes up the floor. Ertan Ghazi looking for his first points, coming off the
one and one. Isaiah, usually a good foul shooter at almost 80%. Simpson on the floor with Henry and Garrett, Hamilton and Ghazi. Ghazi's more of an assist guy, but he throws it up and in.
And there's been an inability by DePaul to contain and keep the guys out of the paint. Josh Hart that time being a playmaker, and Jenkins, who loves that corner pocket.
Ghazi, who's only
the big dunk. DePaul up by four and more points in the paint. Haven't seen that kind of elevation from Henry over the last couple of weeks. It's good to see.
Oh yeah, because they need his scoring ability. And he's a sneaky jumper. He doesn't look like he's going to catch you, but he will if you're not careful.
There goes Ertan Ghazi to the rack.
Isolated. And a
that's a tough matchup right there. You're talking about one of the best freshmen in the country being isolated one-on-one with the skill package he has, and he shows you a nice right-hand soft jumper.
Stimmage did a good job on Ellenson in the first 20 minutes of this ball game. Is Gazi up and under, pretty. 8 of 13 from the floor.
Very strong game by Luke Fisher today, finishing around the basket, catching the ball. Making, definitely making a strong offensive effort in the paint on the block.
Runner by Erten. You mentioned Purvis Ellison just a moment ago. Carter played for Purvis in Jersey. Gazi gets the layup.
His own hook, the answer to the Stimmich hook.
See, what jumps out of me in that play, though, is Ronnie Harrell at the power forward spot, the ability to feed the post. That's something that's eluded great in terms of their lack of post production, is just getting touches. Good pass from Harrell.
Here's Hanley now against Milliken. Quick double team comes, gets rid of it to Gazi, who
splashes. If you're not getting in this one, I don't know when you're getting in.
That's a three from Gazi.
Just the second make of the night for DePaul from distance. Simo, one out of six from beyond the arc.
Right now, DePaul can put the foot down and extend this lead.
There's Gazi, and he's on point. Dave Lato comes away with the rebound. Don't forget, again, coming up after this game, it's the FS1 UFC Fight Night pre-fight show. It's on right now on Fox Sports Go. 90 seconds away is Erten Gazi.
Couple of free. In a lot of crosstown rivals, UIC, then Chicago State, and then Southeast Missouri State, before they go to Vegas to play Wyoming. DePaul going to be happy just to run this clock out. Erten Gazi, nice little ball fake, and he lays it up.
Backbreaker speaks for itself.
George, of course, a former head coach at Holy Cross and was his lieutenant for so many years, all those Final Four runs at national championships.
I used to say Dave Latham was the best guy checking out Calhoun of anybody on the staff.
Indeed.
The game becomes much easier when you have teammates that can recognize, share the ball, and swing it on the double swing. That's how Dwayne Wilson gets a knockdown three.
Inside, and a nice finish from Erten
to get to Ellison.
Ellison, 5-footer, can't get it down.
Good job on the help defense by DePaul, recognizing that they were going to Ellison, being there prepared to give resistance defensively.
Long three, got RJ Curry.
Catch and shoot, coming off ball screens, getting into the mid-range, and because he's a smaller guy, he gives you a little fade jump shot.
Erten Gazi created for Stimmich.
Left side of the iron. Well, I tell you, Little Rock's doing a great job of their gap integrity.
Yep. No, they play that pack line defense, so when there's somebody driving the basketball, they're looking at two to three defenders first half.
DePaul has not made a shot from the field in over 3 minutes. Simpson, after a fake, the three.
Is the leading scorer for Providence. Chris Dunn is the number two scorer for Providence, and he did not start today, has not played yet because of a virus that has been bothering him.
Hamilton feeling it. Back-to-back triples from the